Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for July the 27th of 2020, well, it is titled Comet and Lightning Beyond Bighorn Mountains. So what do we see here? Well, in the foreground, we see the Bighorn Mountains out in Wyoming. And looking out in the sky in the distance towards the right, we can see a great thunderstorm there. And you can see many lightning bolts striking down towards the ground from the clouds. But the thunderstorm is out in the distance, as we can see, because the clouds are off there on the horizon. And up above, we are able to see stars in the sky. So where this observation was, it was not raining or storming. We can actually see there and see the clouds, see the lack of clouds, and actually see the stars there. And one of the things we see up above the mountain is Comet Neowise, one of the things that we've been looking at over the past couple of weeks. And that is a prominent comet now visible in the evening sky. So towards the bottom, we see the head of the comet pointing downward, and the head of the comet always points towards the sun. So the tails are being pushed away by the sun, and that tells us the direction of the sun here, that the sun would have been below the horizon here. And you can see that where the comet is and which direction the tail is pointing. So no matter where the comet is in its orbit, the tail will always point away from the sun. That means that at some point when the comet is approaching, coming into the inner solar system, the tail lags behind the comet. However, when the comet is leaving, the tail will actually be leading the rest of the comet away. So not the way we think of things working here on Earth, but it is how the comet works. And it's because the tail will always have to point away from the sun, because that is how the tail is created. Now, if you haven't had a chance to see Comet Neowise, we're going to be running out of time very quickly, as it's going to begin to get fainter and fainter now that it is moving further away from the Earth and further away from the sun. So the sun energizes it and causes it to glow, and that's going to be decreasing. And the further it gets away from the Earth, the fainter it will get as well. So over the coming days and weeks, it will slowly disappear from sight. Although we've had a very good couple of weeks here with a great comet to be able to see, which is nice after a couple of false starts earlier this year with other comets that we thought might become nice and visible. We finally got our one in Comet Neowise that we were able to see for a period of time, again, even without the aid of binoculars or a telescope, visible to the naked eye. So that was our picture of the day for July the 27th of 2020. It was titled Comet and Lightning Beyond Bighorn Mountains. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Fighting Space Dragons. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.